a great stop there by Fleury.
Boy, was that ever nice. Now, last night in Ottawa, sends defenseman Patrick Wirkut. Nah. One-timer. Wirkut back one. Nah. What are you going to do?
Darn it.
The Sens would score right after Wirkutch's shift. Just 20 seconds later, they would go on to win the hockey game. Poor Patrick. Nobody's laughing at the Sens despite all of their injuries. They just keep on winning. This is a team that refuses to suffer from wounded pride. Now, had you know this, I tend to be a little bit clumsy. Well, a lot clumsy. I've caught many an edge and wasn't even wearing skates. Here's the SportsCenter top 10.
His old stomping grounds in New York.
Zubin lost his footing, turns it over, Stepan walks out, shoots, Price got a piece of the rebound, it's clear. Oh, what a chance for the Rangers.
He's in total confidence, but when you don't have an edge, that's what happened. It's called blowing a tire.
Even the best players in the world can have trouble staying on their feet, as Alex Ovechkin crosses the blue line before tripping over himself against Philly.
Leading 1-0 here in the first period of tonight's game.
Jovo's been known to do that once in a while.
Now Green with it at the blue line. Oops. He tripped over the blue line of it.
Yes, he basically did. And he didn't look very graceful doing it.
Trying not to fall can be a challenge at any time, but it is a little more difficult when you actually lose a blade.
We talked about Lee Stempniak limping to the Flames bench. There you see him. He's looking at his skate, and he realizes he's got no blade.
There's the big hit. He goes down. Well, watch him get up. He tries to lean, falls flat on his face.
Taking falling to a new level, Philadelphia's Scott Hartnell turned his propensity for falling into a charity drive.
Hartnell down. Hartnell down. Hartnell down.
Alexander Semin blows one-on-one against Marty Turkle. Semin strolling in, stumbles, and got too close to the netminder.
Tough break for Semin, not what he had intended.
He's got an empty net and a gimme. Oh, and he missed the net. He fell down, and with 8 seconds left, here come the Oilers. Sikora to Ryan Smith, in front to Hemsky. He scores! In a building where the improbable usually happens, we've just seen the impossible.
Lyman's got great moves, too. I like the way he goes in.
Here he comes. Dennis Weidman fakes it in. He got knocked down by the goaltender. He had a wide-open net.
Actually, he just lost his balance and then fell over the goalie.
Devin Setoguchi to tie this up. Carey Price can win the game.
He just went to pull it back quickly. Puck's rolling, and then the worst possible feeling. Where's the trap door when you need it?
Oh,
to get off the ice.
The absolute worst thing about this is that there's videotape. That is the most bizarre ending to a hockey game I've seen in a long, long time.